thank you for your purchase of a Vector 3 or Vector 3S power meter. By now, you've experienced the benefits of direct measure power measurements as you strive to beat your personal best. After extended use, your Vector 3 series power meter may need routine maintenance. To lubricate your Vector 3 or Vector 3S, you'll need to disassemble each pedal body. Start with the left pedal and then do the right. Begin by removing the battery cap with a 4mm Allen wrench. And use your PH00 Phillips head screwdriver to remove the two small screws. On both the Vector 3 and Vector 3S, the left pedal has standard threads and a silver nut. Loosen the spindle nut with a 12mm socket on a 1/4-inch drive by turning it to the left. Use a pedal wrench to keep the spindle from rotating. Slide out the spindle. Carefully remove the two seals from the pedal body with your small screwdriver so you don't scratch or damage them. Wipe off old grease with a clean rag. Inspect the seals and replace them if they're damaged. Reinstall the inner seal with the cone end facing toward the crank. Press it down so it's flush against the bearing. Slide the second seal onto the shaft of the spindle with its cone facing toward the crank. Apply a good bit of grease to the bearing and push it into the bearing with a cotton swab or your gloved finger. Then add a little bit along the spindle. Insert the spindle into the pedal body. Press the outside seal flush to the pedal body. Be careful to prevent the spindle from sliding out of the pedal body because it may dislodge the seals from their correct locations. Clean excess grease from the electrical connector on the end of the spindle and reinstall the spindle nut with the larger step toward the spindle. Again, using a pedal wrench to keep the spindle from turning, tighten the spindle nut with a 12mm socket and torque it to 10 Newton meters. Replace the battery board. Rotate to align the holes and reinstall the screws. The board should sit flush. Reinstall the batteries. The LED on the crank end of the spindle should illuminate to indicate the pedal has power. You're ready to reinstall the pedal onto your bike with a 15mm pedal wrench. Repeat the procedure on the right pedal. If you have a Vector 3S set, the right pedal will not have parts related to the batteries. Note that the right pedal spindle has reverse threads and a black nut. You'll need to loosen the nut with a 12mm socket by turning it to the right and tighten it by turning it to the left. Once you've reinstalled the pedals, you're ready to go for a ride. Thanks for watching.